Good afternoon. My name is Alan Travaglione, and I'm the Vice President of the Class of 2013. I will be your announcer today. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. May sit. Catherine Colpitz, the class president, will give our official welcome to today's ceremony. Catherine Colpitz.
Welcome, parents, family, and friends, to the Nantucket High School class of 2013's graduation ceremony. Today we celebrate not only the completion of the past 4 years spent in high school, but also the beginning of a new chapter in our lives. I am proud to call myself a graduate of this year's class. It is filled with a diverse set of personalities that seems to always have the ability to come together and support one another, whether at a sports game, a high school musical, or even a fundraising event. These students you see before you have grown into the successful and bright people you see today because of all of you. We have been guided, taught, and encouraged by parents, teachers, and loved ones. I would like to thank our teachers for giving us the support and guidance we need, the administration for doing so also, and family and friends for giving us a reassuring and loving hand as we navigate the obstacles we encounter throughout life. It is you we have to thank for today's accomplishments. Congratulations. So without further ado, I would like to welcome you to today's commencement ceremony for the graduating class of 2013.
Mr. John J. Buckey, Nantucket High School principal, will give opening remarks.
Members of the Nantucket School Committee, Chairman Lepre, Superintendent Kozort, members of the faculty and staff, honored guest parents, and most importantly, members of the graduating class of 2013, good afternoon and welcome to Nantucket High School's 174th graduation ceremony. Each year, I attempt to introduce creatively our graduation speaker. This year, I considered singing Papa, Can You Hear Me from Yentl, as this represented his Broadway debut. But then I realized with an acting career that includes 50 films, 25 plays on and off Broadway, and a starring role as Lex Luthor in TV's Lois and Clark, The New Adventures of Superman, it would not do justice to the impressive talent and career that is John Shea. Thank you for being here and agreeing to address the graduates. I would be remiss to begin our ceremony without a proper acknowledgement of two wonderful women in the main office at NHS who do so much to make this such a dignified and impressive celebration for our graduates. To Cheryl Coffin and Stephanie Hansen, I say thank you. I would also like to thank businesses and individuals who contributed to making today's ceremony more special. To Flowers on Chestnut for the podium flowers and the beautiful flowers that adorn our stage. And to Charles Dragon Landscaping and Portable Party Gardens for the beautiful plants adorning the entryway. Thank you. It is our proud tradition at graduation to recognize and celebrate our alumni. At this time, I would like to invite all graduates celebrating their first, fifth, or 10th year of graduation from Nantucket High School to stand and to be recognized. Graduates from the classes of 1998 and 1993, who graduated 15 and 20 years ago respectively, please stand to be honored. Are there any graduates from the class of 1988 who are here celebrating their 25th reunion? If so, please stand. Would our alumni who are in attendance who graduated 30, 35, 40, I know there is at least one, and 45 years ago with the classes of 1983, 1978, 1973, and 1968, please stand to be honored. We are extremely proud to recognize 10 graduates from the class of 1963 who are with us today to celebrate their 50th class reunion. Please stand and be honored. If there are any graduates from the classes of 1958 or 1953, 1948 or 1943, if so, please stand and be recognized. There are undoubtedly many, many other Nantucket High School alumni with us today, so for the classes that we have not formally called and recognized who are here, please now stand. I see our commencement ceremony also being about the countless people who have supported these young people, soon to be our graduates, throughout the years. With this in mind, I would like the teachers, teaching assistants, coaches, and support staff who have played important roles in the lives of these students from kindergarten through grade 12 to stand and be recognized and honored. And now back to the graduates. The yellow cords designate honor roll status. I wish to recognize those students, Ella Blossi, Stephen Brown, Alexa Crosby, Beatrice Gillum, Keaton Goddard, Juliet Lefebvre, Kylie McGuire, Brittany Moreau, Julia Newman, Wasima Nitpat Nantaporn, Jimmy Portillo Ramirez, Emily Sylvia, and Lillian Sylvia. Congratulations. The white sashes are worn by members of the National Honor Society, and for two illustrious graduates, I would like to honor their academic achievement for having maintained principal's list status, all A's in all subjects throughout their senior year, Sean Allen and JoJo Zeef. The class of 2013 has made its mark. While the smallest class to graduate in recent memory, they have contributed largely to our community. Nearly a third of the class was out in the community participating in school to career. The class of 2013 is the first class to have community service among its graduation requirements. On the last day of classes, many students, rather than participating in a negative prank, use their energies to go out into the community and participate in service. Offshore Animal Hospital happily welcomed 19 members of the class that day. This class exceeded expectations, contributing literally hundreds of hours of service on our island. They have been unique in contributing individuals, but they have also been a very tightly knit class. They say no one ever remembers what is said in a graduation speech. You're going to remember that. Who they are, I'm not sure, but despite their revelations, I'm going to offer a few remarks before ceding the microphone to our other speakers. Nantucket High School is a unique place, as we well know. I still remember when I walked into the Hall of the Whale for the first time. I believe my initial reaction was, wow, now that's a high school. The main office looks out into the hallway. I now notice the same reaction as athletes and visitors from other schools and places come into our school. More important than the impressive building, however, is what goes on in our school.
Your hard work makes our awards and accolades possible today. Any institution has its faults, but I think you will find that graduating from Nantucket High School is an extraordinary asset. Not many people are granted an educational experience quite like this. As you make your way through life, I hope that you will use what you have learned to advance your own personal goals and to improve the lives of those around you. Think of what we could accomplish as a country if more students had Nantucket experiences. At our last faculty meeting of the year, I asked our staff to provide me some words they would like to offer the graduates. Many ask that you remember the nurturing community you have come from. Others remind you that there will be failures and disappointments, but how you handle those will determine what kind of person you will become. Some of your teachers implore you to be conscious of your values, choices, and manners, to be responsible, respectful, and polite. Quote, you are the culmination of your life's events. You are not defined by one event. Some offer humorous insights like put down your iPhone and enjoy the moment. Or be kind and wear sunscreen. Everything else is optional. All of your teachers desire for you to make us proud and return to us to share your successes. One of our staff members suggested a quote by Viktor Frankl, which I will use as it makes a nice transition to the next part of my remarks. The last of the human freedoms is to choose one's attitudes. As you move forward, I encourage you to choose happiness. I know this might sound a bit trite, but it's the most articulate way I can put it. Happiness is a choice, it is not a condition. Life will throw you some curveballs if it hasn't already. Obviously, we cannot control everything that happens to us, but we are in charge of how we respond in various situations. Simple things can make us happy. Sometimes it's not the day at Disney World, but the conversations on the way there. I'm not encouraging you to be delusional. Is being a nuclear surgeon, astronaut, the only thing that will make you happy? Hopefully not. Regardless, your perceptions and attitudes really do shape your reality. You might recall Henry Ford's quip, if you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. It's essentially true. So why not choose to challenge yourself, and why not choose happiness? As you leave Nantucket High School and perhaps even the island, how you mentally approach the next chapter in your lives will influence how successful that chapter might be. Mindset is important. Carol Dweck is the author of the book, Mindset, The New Psychology of Success. In her book, she discusses two types of mindset, fixed and growth. To grossly oversimplify for our purposes today, people who ascribe to the idea of a fixed mindset believe their basic qualities, like their intelligence or talent, are simply fixed traits. They spend their time documenting their intelligence or talent instead of developing it. They seek a safe and tried approach, thriving on the sure thing. They also believe that talent alone creates success without factoring in effort or strategy. This is a self-limiting belief leading to lost opportunities for personal growth. On the other side is a growth mindset. People believe that their most basic abilities can be developed through effort and strategy. Brains and talent are just the starting point. This view creates a love of learning and a resilience that is essential for accomplishment. Our basic qualities can be cultivated through our effort and application of effective strategies. People with a growth mindset are characterized by stretch yourself and stick to it, even when things are not going well. This is a self-liberating belief leading to personal and professional growth. Choose the growth mindset and keep growing. Savor where you are and what you have, but look ahead and dig into the challenges. Keep exploring. Stay friends with your BFF since elementary school, but for goodness sake, get to know other people. People who are perhaps quite different from you. Don't be afraid to laugh in tough situations, and sometimes to laugh at yourselves. Believe me, we are still working on these goals too, but I hope you'll remember these basic ideals as you move forward. Choose happiness and keep growing. Think about where you're headed and where you want to go. Life after high school is another chapter, and you are the author. Know that we are thinking of you, rooting for you, and praying for you. Do well and do good, Whalers. On behalf of the faculty and staff of Nantucket High School, I wish to each of you your chosen happiness and a life of continuous growth. May the kindness of your fellow human beings and the love of your family and friends sustain and support you. Congratulations again, graduates of 2013.
Mr. W. Michael Kozer, Superintendent of Schools, will now say a few words.
Thank you, Alan, and thank you, graduates. I'd like to welcome all the parents, relatives, community members who are here to support our graduates. 2 years ago, I started a tradition here of talking about my memories of each class, and I would like to continue with that today. You all have your own memories that you will take with you from your experience at Nantucket High School. I'm sure some are fond, and some are perhaps a little bit painful. I hope over time that the ones that ache will recede in your memory, and the tender ones will forever be remembered. So here's my journey with this class, 2013. On Nantucket, it didn't take me long to learn that much is defined by the Vineyard Games. Football had a heartbreaking loss. We beat that team for 3.5 quarters. And I've never been prouder of our boys. In girls' soccer, there was a tie that felt like a loss. In boys' soccer, an unbelievable comeback win with Caleb and Chris scoring goals. Actually, a side story is that Caleb, at the end of graduation last year, asked me to promise if he scored a goal that I would mention it this year. So, in girls lacrosse, I remember an incredible 11-10 come from behind for their first win ever over the girls in purple. In baseball, it was nice to see that we came back and won the second game after having lost the first. And in softball, oh right, they wouldn't play us in softball. I remember Christian, actually 2 years ago, I think, in goal-saving penalty kicks to win a playoff game. It was an incredible performance. And he came up to me after that and said, "Do you think you would have scored against me today?" My answer was no. I will always remember Sean Davis looking like he just stepped out of a page of Gentleman's Quarterly. And Beatrice and Kara like they just stepped out of Vogue. I will remember my soccer boys, Ben, Nick, Stephen, Chris, Brandon, Tony, and their teams, their Nantucket Whaler teams, but their Chelsea and their Man U and Man City. And JoJo as the only Liverpool fan joining me. And by the way, Brandon and Stephen, sorry about your reggae boys last night against the U.S. I will remember our distinguished young woman, Julia Newman, talented in so many ways. Alex in Footloose and Guys and Dolls. Dakota in Enchanted April. Sean Allen, Catherine, Julia, Emily, gifted actors, actresses, and singers. I will remember Terrell's signing day. And Tiffany and Tanisha singing the national anthem, something no one could pay me enough to do. I remember Jordan working with children in Mrs. Meyer's classroom. I remember Alexa, unstoppable in soccer, Casey, unstoppable in field hockey, and Monica and Devin, unstoppable in lacrosse. I remember watching one day, and I'm sure they never saw me, Victor and Casey in Breakfast Buddies working with some elementary school children. I remember our prom queen, Rakeem Baker. I will remember our swim team, Jack, Miles, TJ, Tavio, Taylor, diving. I will remember our senior ball, sharing parents with your moments, and in particular, Keegan's paisley pants. I will remember Ella Blasi and Keaton and Alan and Alexa Dragon, quiet but smart and an inner strength. I will remember Lily's artwork. Kate Freed, so sweet in the halls but tough as nails on the field. There's always a place for her on my team. I'll remember Badminton Mania, Sam and Mr. Hudak in their costumes, and my partner, John Montgomery. Cooper, describing himself as the anti-football guy who converted and loved it. Marshall, a very tough senior year physically, but kept it together. I'm proud of you. Ian, winning the laptop the other night. Dylan Perry, one of our few three-sport athletes who played hard and always played the right way. Tanisha's smile. I will remember MJ Caro's standing ovation at Academic Awards Night. Caleb, Keegan, Ben, and their blue man raising school spirit running all over the field or the basketball courts. I will remember with pride all of the candidates for the Nantucket Scholars, 19 amazing young men and women. I wish you all could have been a fly on the wall to watch that process. You would have been so proud of all of those students. Although I would not diminish the selection of JoJo and Sam, two amazing and deserving scholars, you would have had to be in the room to fully comprehend how incredible every student was. It was astonishing and it was gratifying. The athletic games were the vineyard, the plays, the concerts, the drama productions, the senior ball. These events will be scratched indelibly in my mind forever. But that is so because of these students, particularly these seniors who have accomplished so many amazing things. I'm a Liverpool soccer fan. For those of you who would watch the English Premier League, you'll understand that in recent years, this is like a confession or an admission of guilt. But I was standing at Anfield when Chelsea played Liverpool this spring, and yes, that's the game when Suarez took a bite out of Ivanovic, and there were over 40,000 people singing this song, "You'll Never Walk Alone." It's actually from Rodgers and Hammerstein. And it goes like this: when you walk through the storm, hold your head up high, and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song of the lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never walk alone. And that's been adapted as the theme song for Liverpool, but it struck me that night that if you grow up on Nantucket, you will never walk alone. You will, of course, always have the support of your family, but you will also have support of this amazing community that watched over you as you grew up. Remember your roots and be proud of them. You live in a beautiful place, and one, I might add, that is recognized the world over. I hope your time in the Nantucket Public Schools has been rewarding and has prepared you for whatever challenges lay ahead. I know that your time here has enriched my life and given it both joy and purpose. I wish you all the very best in the future. And at this time, I'd like to ask the students to join me. We added a tradition that I brought from my old school district a few years ago, and it's an opportunity for our seniors to take a flower or two and to thank the people who helped them get where they are this evening. Seniors?
I don't know.
three. I'm sure you know better than I do. So just bear with us, please.
Where's my mom?
A couple more over here. Keaton Goddard, the second highest ranking student, will now deliver the salutatory address. Keaton Goddard.
Welcome family, friends, staff, and community members to today's commencement ceremony. Abraham Lincoln once said, "It's not the years in your life that count, it's the life in your years." In my 4 years here at Nantucket High School, I have witnessed and experienced much life, and I have learned that in life there is nothing more valuable than a comfortable couch. In fifth grade, my family and I moved to a different house here on the island. And with that house came a blue couch. It is hard to believe that this blue couch would come to mean so much more than simply a place to sit. During the beginning of my senior year, my father decided that the couch was too old and a bit too smelly to keep. We loaded it up into our truck and drove to the main road, dropping it off in front of my cousin's house with a freeze sign attached to it. And within 2 hours, it was gone. I thought that would be the last time I would ever see the couch. The couch I spent many years sitting on comfortably, but little did I know I would see that couch again. A few weeks later, we had an assembly in this very auditorium, and there it was, basking in all its glory on stage as a prop for the upcoming drama club play, and I thought, oh, that looks familiar. The couch that I thought I had bid farewell to was now sitting in the very school I went to every day. A few months later, I was sitting in my AP Calculus class when my teacher, Mr. Sardellis, interjected into his own lesson, asking the class in a most serious tone.
Standing in for Mr. Sardellis. Does anyone have a coach?
Hey, the drama club has one.
A student said, and it was settled. That class, we were not learning how to integrate or derive an equation. We were stealing a couch, my old couch, from the drama club. The 11 of us, including Mr. Sardellis, left the classroom and scouted the area around the auditorium, making sure not to get caught by any of the administrators or teachers and having to answer the question we were trying so hard to avoid, what are you doing? Once we realized the couch would not fit in the elevator, we recruited Celso to help us secretly maneuver it upstairs while our strategically posted lookouts kept watch. After successfully pulling off our heist, Mr. Sardellis' room had a new addition, a couch that would forever leave the 2013 AP Calculus class's mark. Most importantly, the couch was a symbol of comfort, something that Nantucket High School has provided me and its students with throughout the years. Lincoln said that it is the life in your years that count, but it is also the comfort, for without comfort you cannot grow. My family, friends, and teachers and staff here at Nantucket High School have given me a support system and a foundation to be successful in life. They have instilled in me the sense of comfort necessary to be myself. Towards the end of my senior year, I brought Mr. Sardellis the final components of the blue couch, its matching pillows, to make it the most comfortable couch at Nantucket High School. As I and my classmates leave here today as graduates of this school, we leave our legacy. We also leave the comfort of our own personal couch, journeying off to accomplish our highest goals in life, saying goodbye to all that is familiar to us. As we move on, we remember the people we have encountered in our lives who have impacted us so deeply. These are the people who have shaped us to be who we are today and given us the comfort that makes us feel whole. No matter where our journey takes us, we can always return home to a comfortable couch of our own. However, I challenge you, the class of 2013, to get off your couch, get out of your comfort zone, and go fill your life, your years with life. Thank you.
Joseph Jerry Sweetzeef, the highest ranking student, will now deliver the valedictory address. Joseph.
So how about that ride in? I guess that's why they call it Sin City. First off, I would like to thank all the parents, families, friends, and teachers of the class of 2013, as your support, care, and unconditional love have been such an instrumental part of our progression, navigation, and completion of the last 4 years of high school. I know without my love, support, and influence of my father and my mother, I would not have grown to be the person I am today, and I am forever thankful for that. Ben and Caitlin, I guess you guys are good too. 3 years and 9 months ago, I walked through the doors of Nantucket High School for the first time as a student. After graduating from the Nantucket New School in a class of three, I was intimidated by the larger student body, the new classes, and the unfamiliar faces. Now today, at our graduation ceremony, after walking through these doors more times than one could ever count, we have traversed through these doors for the last time as Nantucket High School students. However, as we leave the school in which we have been so invested over the last 4 years, we cannot help but be proud of what we have accomplished and the indelible footprint we have left on Nantucket High School, the island community, and each other. Living on an island separated from the mainland by 30 miles of Atlantic Ocean, a unique sense of community develops between the school and the island. An environment where the school and the surrounding community are intertwined, where the island supports the school, and in turn, the school supports the island. The Nantucket community provides its undying support for the athletic events, musical performances, theatrical works, and the academic growth and educational maturity that has gotten us to this graduation today. This support is universal to all the aspects of a diverse student body with different interests, passions, and talents. The support does not change or dwindle between the beautiful and sunny months of the spring and summer and the bitter cold months of January and February. In turn, we students give the community a source of entertainment, confidence, and a pride in Nantucket High School students as ambassadors for the future. It is this type of relationship that has made growing up in Nantucket and being a member of Nantucket High School student body so special and unique. As a class, we've continuously represented Nantucket High School in a commendable way, inside and outside of the classroom. Through hard work and determination, Whalers Athletics have seen many great and successful seasons over the last 4 years in a number of different sports. Over the last 4 years, we have seen endless talent of our class through the many musical and theatrical performances. In the last 4 years, the class of 2013 has effectively represented and impressed the island of Nantucket in many different fields and in many different ways. It is because of this that although our time at Nantucket High School may be over, our impression and influence on the community of Nantucket is timeless. However, what may be as important as the relationships we have created with the island are the relationships that we have created with each other. Being the centerpiece of such a close-knit community, Nantucket High School has been a place of camaraderie and pride that has fostered the building of strong relationships and everlasting friendships. Being in a close-knit school and community has allowed us to create meaningful and enduring connections with teachers, classmates, parents, and community members that have the potential to last much longer. I feel lucky and extremely grateful to have been a student at Nantucket High School and a member of the class of 2013. As we now progress towards adulthood and move along our different paths through life, it is important to know that we will all face obstacles and difficulties. There will be hurdles to jump and obstacles to climb. There will be people who tell you that you can't, and sometimes a task or objective may feel impossible. It is important to know that through hard work, determination, and belief, one can navigate through the most treacherous of oceans. World-famous boxer and cultural icon Muhammad Ali once was quoted saying, "Impossible is just a big word thrown around by small men who find it easier to live in the world they've been given than to explore the power they have to change it. Impossible is not a fact, it's an opinion. Possible is not a declaration, it's a dare. Impossible is potential, impossible is temporary, impossible is nothing. Something is only impossible if you believe it is impossible." Through hard work and determination, the most difficult of tasks and the highest ambitions can be achieved. Whether these obstacles or difficulties come tomorrow, next year, or many years on, it's important to attack them with confidence, self-belief, and perseverance to achieve your ultimate goal and to explore the power you have to change the world. Lastly, before I finish, I want to thank the teachers, the administration, and the entire faculty at Nantucket High School for fostering an environment where learning is plentiful, accessible, and enjoyable. I am confident that their passion and devotion is largely responsible for making Nantucket High School such a special and unique community. The relationships I have developed with the faculty are extremely valuable and are relationships I will always carry. As the class of 2013 graduates from Nantucket High School, we will always remain members of the Nantucket High School community. And it gives me great comfort that the memories we have had and the relationships we have built will remain for many years to come. Thanks, everyone. As my grandfather always said, and often mangled, may the best days of your past be the worst days of your future. Thank you.
Thank you, JoJo and Keaton. Mr. John Shea, commencement speaker, will now say a few words to our class and the audience.
Thank you very much. Okay, I just want to say a couple things. Joe, thank you very much for your remarks. Keaton, great. I love that couch story. I spent some time on that couch too, I think. I think we borrowed it over for the theater. I'm going to move this mic up because, I don't know, am I taller? There. How's that? Better? Okay, thanks. I'm so happy to be here. The school committee, you know, had the money in the budget. They said, we'll bring you in from anywhere. And I said, they said, where do you live? And I said, Sconset. They said, except for Sconset. Okay. They did kick in some gas money, and I appreciate that. Thank you. And apparently there's food afterward, and I told them I work for food, and so hot dogs in the cafeteria. I wrote that little piano piece. I want you to say you played it really well. It's a little repetitive. We could do a little boogie-woogie maybe next year, something in there. The baton guy, you know, that guy. I worked with him for 2 weeks. I'm a little disappointed that he didn't get a little more variety in it. Okay, can I just say, all right? We had a song go down. We had, you know, I can't wait to get out of this gown. You know, I'm, and we had it spinning. He was spinning in rehearsal. I don't know. Well, but anyway, thank you for that. These flowers here, okay, I grew these flowers. I picked these flowers. Let's get the facts straight, okay? The guy who tripped coming up the stairs, that's my favorite moment so far. Okay? I love that. Can you stand up? Who are you? Can you stand up just for a second? Who tripped? All right, there you go. That's a real moment. That's a real moment. I wanted to do that my whole life. I get paid to do that sometimes. I'll show you. But you did it for real, man. That was awesome, you know. And he recovered. You know, it's not the trip, it's the recovery. He waved, right? Like he planned that, you know. It was great. I didn't get a flower. Did you? How many here didn't get flowers, okay? Do you feel like I feel a little left out? I got a petal, okay? Every single graduate who came down here stepped on my feet. I'm sitting in the front row here, every single one. I'm feeling a little hurt, you know. What did I do to you? Nothing, okay? This thing fell, but what the heck? I haven't worn a dress since I did, you know, musical back in high school, but I'm wearing one now, and I feel pretty. I've been waiting for an idea to come to me. I, you know, all it says so far is, thank you, Joe, and that was for you, Joe, you know. And that's, so I decided to pull out an old speech that I gave when I got out of a maximum security prison outside of Boston at the AA meeting after my detox. And so some of you will relate to that speech, I'm sure. I just wanted to say, you know, you didn't mention this, John. You know, give a great speech and thank you, but, you know, I won a Tony Award, okay? I won an award from Tony Vieira, who turns out gave awards out to guys at the Chicken Box every year. But I did win a Tony, okay? The school paper's called Veritas, which means I have no idea what I mean. No, it means truth. We know this, okay? So I want to see if I can tell a little bit of the truth today. And you know, you're the living, and I don't understand why you're behind me and I'm talking to your parents. They already know everything, right? So I feel like I should give the whole speech like this, but then they're going to see the back of my head, and then I feel maybe I should give it in profile. How's that? Is that better? You know what I'm saying. I mean, everybody's talking out here like they care, but it's about you. And I remember when I was 18 and graduating. So I thought that when I needed to begin the speech officially. So I want to say, you know, parents and grandparents and the administration and Principal Bucky and Superintendent Corzart and Chairman Tim Leprey, 25 years, Tim, in and out of a school. He told me about his mother who ran for the school board. You know, so this goes way back. The former graduates who came to the graduation, you know, I never graduated from high school. Yes, I did. But you and the graduates, 84 of you, my fellow students, I feel like I'm a student. This is the 174th, you heard John say it, 174th graduation, okay? But let's just do the math. That means that we're in 2013, that the Nantucket High School started in 1839, right? But Nantucket was founded in 1659, so what did they do for 200 years? Okay? I mean, talk about the good old days. I mean, we clearly missed the boat. For 200 years, no school, and then suddenly 1859, they said, okay, let's have a high school. So the bad news is 175 years later, we've had to go to school a lot, right? So we are all students. And we are all teachers. We're all teachers, we're all students. Everybody in this room, everybody in this island, everybody in this state, everybody in the country, everybody in the world, all students. We're all in this great classroom, right? The great classroom of life. And Shakespeare said, all the world's a stage. I'm gonna say, no, all the world's a school. And we're all just students. And we're all just teachers. So I ask myself the question often, why are we born? Why are we born? Why do we have to go through this? Why do we have to wear dresses? Okay? And the answer is because we're here to learn. We are here to learn. We are born to learn from the moment that Tim Leprey pulls you out of the womb and spanks you on the butt. You know, you learn to forgive Tim. You learn to breathe air instead of whatever it's called, amniotic fluid. You learn to scream and howl for food. You learn to find your mother's breast, you know? You learn. You learn to walk and crawl and talk and stand and run and read and write and play and eat and tie your shoes and brush your teeth and cry even louder when somebody is making too much noise. And if you don't brush your teeth, you get cavities and you go to the dentist and he drills you, like my son Caden the other day, and he now learns the consequences of action or inaction. He's learning all the time. We learn to copy our parents. It's because it's monkey see, monkey do, just like the animals. If your parents are good and loving, you're going to be good and loving probably. If your parents are animals, if your parents are hateful or bigoted or selfish, you're going to learn about that too, right? You're going to learn what to do, what not to do. We learn. We mirror the life around us. Our parents are our first teachers. And our brothers and sisters, they're our teachers too. They teach us to be patient because they drive us crazy, right? We learn to share with them. And we learn to laugh, and we learn to forgive them. And we learn basic, elemental things, how to play. And on it goes, on and on and on, until one day we go to school, and we learn to separate ourselves from our parents, and we get new parents, and those parents are called teachers. And we get new brothers and sisters, and they're called classmates. And we learn with these people in our surrogate home, away from home, like this home. You know, we have substitute people. And slowly but surely, we learn our ABCs and our 1-2-3s, and we learn to write and add and subtract and the world around us. We learn about the world inside us, and we learn about the plants and the animals and the oceans and the forests and the countries and other languages and customs and religions, and in and out of church, we learn about God and the higher powers, and we learn about angels and the invisible world and multi-dimensions, and we learn about the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not kill, steal, cheat, lie, right? These are basic good things. We're learning, constantly learning. And we learn about the atoms in the skin and the blood and the bones and the eyes and the knee bones connected to the shin bone, and it's all true. And it never stops. We have nuclei, and we got atoms, and we got molecules inside us, and they're going crazy, and we grow older and stronger and bigger, and we lose our baby teeth that other teeth grow in. And then we learn about the tooth fairy. If you don't toot our pillow and onto the pillow, the tooth fairy won't come and leave us money. And then we learn about, oh my God, so much more. We go to first grade and second grade and third grade and fourth grade and fifth grade and sixth grade and seventh grade and eighth grade. And then one day we go to high school. We can't believe we're in high school. High school, we're big kids all of a sudden. We're big kids. And our bodies go crazy. We start growing hair in places that shouldn't be growing, right? And our breasts get bigger, and that's really weird, and our legs get longer, we get strong and fast, and hormones take over. We got testosterone, we got estrogen, and oh my God, that guy you thought was so ugly, he's looking kind of cute. And we got all kinds of facts and figures to memorize, and we learn to discover what we like and what we're good at, and where our talents may lie. And we got learned so much, and we work so hard. You know, we learn to dream, and we think this is never going to end. These high school years, they're golden. But then one day they say, what about college? What are you going to do after graduation? You say, wait a minute, what do you mean? I got to graduate, I got to leave this? And you go, yeah, you got more learning to do. And you got to apply to college. Or you got to think about other things that you want to do instead of going to college. What are you going to do after graduation, okay? So for 18 years, you guys have been working nonstop, learning all this stuff, and your body's been going crazy. I want to say, just for a minute, let's stop for a second. Let's talk about where you've been and where you're going to go, okay? Here's a moment to stop. Just pause. Put it on pause just for a second. Not so fast. Let's just look around. First of all, where are we? You're on stage. You're wearing funny clothes. We're in a theater, on an island, in a state, in a country, on a world, on a planet, spinning in a solar system, in a universe. Okay? Now, let's ask this question. How many schools are there in the United States of America? Just to narrow it down a little bit, okay? No, there are 133,000 schools in America, and of those schools, there are 40,000 high schools. 40,000 high schools in America. 40,000, 30,000 public, 10,000 private. 40,000. How many schools, high schools, are there on islands in America? Do you know? Anybody want to take a guess? How many do you think? Okay, so there's Nantucket, yeah, there's Martha's Vineyard. And there's Vinyl Haven and Catalina and Block Island, Staten Island and Hilton Head and some of the islands off the state of Washington. There's the Florida Keys. Some of them have high schools, right? There's the territories. Even if you add in Samoa, there's only about 100 high schools that are on islands. You went to a high school on an island. So there's 100 high schools on islands, and there's 40,000 high schools in the United States of America. Okay, those odds are unbelievable that you chose to be born to these parents who brought you here to this island and get this education. The odds, as they say in Vegas, are slim. Now, what makes Nantucket different? We talked a little bit about that in some of the earlier speeches. Okay, there's 83 of you in your class. Am I right? There's 83, 84, 83, 81. Okay, two just dropped out. Okay, on the way down the aisle, they just dropped out, okay. And like America itself, you are a mixed kind of class. You're just, you know, there's nothing exactly the same about all of you, you know. There's new immigrants, there's old immigrants. You're both from Bulgaria and Thailand and Jamaica and Mexico, and you're Native American, and you're islanders. 80% of you are going to college, 20% aren't, not yet. Anyway, you're going to the military, you're going to the police forces, you haven't decided, you're going to travel, you're going to do other things. You're independent thinkers. Okay, good. That's sort of like the world. The religions, there's religious diversity, just like there's ethnic diversity and all the other cultural diversities. So what makes you the same? The question is, what unites you and makes you the class of 2013 from Nantucket High School, this one little island in the middle of nowhere, out of 40,000 high schools in America in a universe that has countless planets? And the answer, I believe, is this community. I went to see John Bucky, where before I gave the speech, I said, John, tell me something about this class. Tell me something about this school. And I said, what makes it so special? I've lived on Nantucket for 45 years. I've never been to Nantucket High School. I didn't go to school here, right? I grew up in Springfield, Western Mass. So he said, well, John, really, what that Nantucket High School graduation is all about is about the community in which these people live, in which they have grown up. So this is not just the graduation celebration for this class. It's a celebration for the whole community, for the mothers and the fathers and the grandparents and the teachers and the administration and the coaches and everybody in the community who has helped support you to get you to this place, this launch pad called today. Okay? And what, I said to John, else makes this island of Nantucket and this high school of Nantucket, where you now are the award-winning sort of best new principal of this great new high school, what makes it so special? Congratulations to John Bucky, by the way, you know? Awesome job in bringing it, you know, like, up to par. Now, the question is, what makes it so great? He said, John, what you have to understand, that's John to me, he said, is that Nantucket is like a college campus. It's like a high school campus, a big campus for these graduates and anybody else coming up. That these graduates don't just go to Nantucket High School, which is an island on an island. No, no, no. Nantucket High School has tentacles, has a campus that goes across this island. You know, if you're interested in medicine, you go see Tim and you apprentice in the hospital. If you're interested in the music stuff, you go over to the Nantucket Music School. If you're interested in movie making, you go hang out at the film festival. If you're interested in the theater, you come hang out at the theater workshop. If you're interested in the trades, you go hang out with any builder on this island who's going to help you teach how to do the trades, right? You want to be a police officer? Then you can work in law enforcement because the chief of police here is going to open his doors to you. And so, if you want to work in science and marine biology, you go down to the UMass. I mean, this is an amazing island. And you look at all those other islands, like I just mentioned, that have the other 99 high schools. It's rare that you're going to find an island like Nantucket that has the opportunities that have been offered to you and will continue to be offered to you. So this island is a campus for the arts, for the trades, for anything you want. You felt it when you were in Little League. You felt it when you were playing rugby. You felt it, lacrosse, and you felt it in soccer and figure skating. And those of you who are interested in mechanics, you could hang out at the Demo Derby. And those of you who are interested in sailing could hang out at the Opera House Cup. It's an amazing place. And you can serve apprenticeships as interior designers. Some of you have want to be chefs, and you've worked in restaurants. You've done landscaping. You want to work in conservation. You can go work at the Conservation Foundation. And so what we have here is a community celebration today. So we have a small island, but it's a generous island. It's an open island. But here's the bad side, the downside of being small. You can't get away with anything on this island. Okay, you can't hide. I'm telling you right now. You can't steal, you can't cheat, you can't do anything wrong because we're going to find out about it in a heartbeat. The island reflects it immediately. It's going to get you. Okay, and it's going to force you to become better than you are and better than you even want to be. Word gets around. Okay? There's a story, and a really ugly story, about some guys who were with I won't even tell that story. Let's just say a body got thrown in the harbor, and then they thought that they were done with that body. Guess what? The tide brought it back in. The tide brings it back in always when you do something wrong in Nantucket, because those guys went to jail. They learned their lessons. They're back in school, even though that school was a maximum security prison, same one that I went to outside of Boston. Okay? And what they learned is that what you put out there comes back to you very quickly on Nantucket, because the laws of karma are in full effect on Nantucket. So I came here when I was 19 years old, about a year older than you guys are. I had just graduated from high school. I was in my first year at college. I came here to get away from my family, who was over on the Cape. I had three sisters. I wanted to adventure on my own. I came over to Nantucket in the summer of 1968. I walked into the theater the first night I was here, and I got lucky, and I found something of my calling. I had, and this is sort of now the kind of remarks that I want to just kind of prepare you for. I think that it is important that you begin, if you haven't already done, to prepare a philosophy that is going to sustain you after you graduate. And by this, I'm going to talk about a little bit about the stories, a couple of little stories. So as a 19-year-old, I grew up as a Catholic. I can still speak the Latin Mass. I can still say things like, "Suscipiat Domini sacrificium de manibus tuis et laudem et gloriam, nomine utilitatem quoque nostrum tutiusque ecclesia sui sancte." But growing up Irish Catholic in Springfield, when you come to a place like Nantucket, Nantucket is a global community with people from all over the world, and suddenly Springfield, Massachusetts seemed like a very provincial little place. And on Nantucket, I learned about Tibetan Buddhism. I learned that there was such a thing as astral traveling. I learned how to meditate, because the Maharishi Mahesh Yogi sent disciples that summer to teach transcendental meditation. I learned that if you look inside yourself as well as outside yourself, you see a vast beauty, more interesting and more profound even than the beauty around us in the physical universe. And so I began to discover, as you have already discovered or will discover, that there is a great world inside as there is a great world outside. I learned how to throw the I Ching, the Book of Changes that Confucius used 5,000 years ago, and I learned to get in touch with my intuition. I met a girl on Main Street in front of Mitchell's bookstore, and I fell in love with her, and we got married. She came up to Bates with me. We went to Yale together. We married for 25 years. The marriage went up in smoke. I got a divorce. Had a beautiful child. I was in a world of pain. What do I do? Oh, my Lord. I had made a lot of movies. I won awards. I had a touch of fame and so a lot of money, and guess what? I lost everything. Everything. Like that, gone. Like one of those dandelions that you blow in the spring after they've budded. Like that, gone. So the question is, what do you do when crisis comes? And the answer is, you find out who you're made of in a moment of crisis. The Chinese say, the Chinese word for crisis is the same word as the word for opportunity. And you have an opportunity then when you're broken open, because we are born to grow, to learn, to fly, to soar, to glide, and then oftentimes we crash. And we crawl, and it really hurts. And the question is, how do you get back up to fly again? And the answer is, I think, if I would start now thinking about a spiritual philosophy that will sustain you in the times when you are in trouble and you need help, all right? This island prepared me to recover from disaster because it gave me the financial, the spiritual and financial and the sociological and the emotional and the spiritual support system that I needed, and it's the way it's given it to you. You will find your own spiritual tools. I would suggest that if you grew up only studying Christian religions, study Eastern religions. If you only studied Eastern religions, study the Western religions. Study psychology. Come to understand what addictions are. Come to understand how to maintain your health, because in the long run, that's really what matters, that you find a balance. Stay strong. If you're an athlete, stay an athlete. Learn to say no. Practice your willpower, because without willpower, all the physical strength in the world won't do you any good. You have to learn how to say no to temptations that are going to come your way. And you know how you practice that? You know how you get stronger? By practice. Say no to that dessert that you shouldn't eat, or the drugs that somebody's offered to you. Just say no, okay? Live a balanced life. You're going to have a great sexual life, but study something that is called sexual kung fu. Yeah, sexual kung fu, where you learn how to take the sexual energy and turn it into spiritual energy. An amazing thing. Learn about the chakra system. Listen to your intuition and your inner self. Listen to the angels around you. Listen to your ancestors who will speak to you when you least expect it. Because you are on a journey and you will continue to learn. And the learning will happen whether you want to or not. Because the world is your school. The Dalai Lama said, we are all different people all over the world, all 8 billion of us, but we have one thing in common. We all beat with the same heart. We have one heart, and it all beats the same way. It goes thump, 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 in you, and you, and you, and everybody on the stage, and all your teachers, and everybody on the island, and everybody in the world. And we all want one thing. What do we want? We want to love, and we want to be loved. That one heart is the thing that unites us. And I would say, listen to that heart. And I would also say, find your mission. What is your mission? And let me tell you that the mission is going to come to you. The mission, if you don't find your mission, the mission will find you. You're going to find out what you're meant to do. When I graduated from high school, I didn't know what I wanted to do. I had never acted before in my life. Since then, you heard him say, I've made all these films, stuff like that. I had no idea in high school. Nothing, no idea. Let me tell you how I found my mission. The great poet Wallace Stevens said, we climb to heaven on the stairway of surprise. We climb to heaven on the stairway of surprise. Surprises are going to happen. When you walked up the stairs on that stairway of surprise, you didn't expect to trip, but you did. You fell, but you got back up. That's the stairway of surprise. Let me tell you how I found my mission. I was at Bates College in my sophomore year. I hurt my knee playing football. I couldn't play football. So the team captain said to me, you're useless on the football team. Why don't you go over and get some beer for us at the store? Because you make the best fake IDs on campus. Because when I went to school, you had to be, you know, like 21. Okay? Guess what? I went over to the back of the theater. I was a debater. And I was on the varsity debating team, as well as the football team. And I went over there to get my fake ID. And as I walked into the back of the theater to get my fake ID from the debate room, this woman, who was the head of the theater, saw me. And she said, Mr. Shea, come here. Sit down. Read this. And there were 12 other people sitting at a table. And she said, she read this. And I couldn't say no. This woman was 6 foot tall. She looked like a Viking. She had great white hair. She was 85 years old. She was Lavinia Schaefer. It was like, okay, Ms. Schaefer, you know your teachers, right? At the end of the reading, she said, you've got the part. I said, what do you mean? She said, we start rehearsal on Monday. You've just auditioned for the next play we're going to do on stage here at Bates College. It's called Much Ado About Nothing by William Shakespeare, and you just got the lead. I had to learn how to do Shakespeare and memorize iambic pentameter, and it changed my life.
And I learned, I was a pre-government major, I learned that the theater was the combination of football and debating. And there was like a team sport, and I loved it. And I found my mission, okay? But then I you're graduating from high school 4 years ago, you maybe graduated from college or something else. Then I had to figure out, oh my God, what am I gonna do next? So I read about one day I was sitting in the library and I read the New York Times, and there was an article about the Yale Repertory Company and the Yale Drama School. I said, Yale, I never heard of it, never, what, drama school. I went down to Yale, I said, I'm gonna go to school there. I applied, I drove my Volkswagen bus from Lewiston, Maine to New Haven, Connecticut. I got on the stage, I did my much ado about nothing speech, and they said, Mr. Shea, now you gotta do your improv. I said, what improv? They said, well, this is a surprise. So a guy came walking across the stage, and I said, what do you want to do to me? He said, no, I'm in the school. What do you want to do? It's your audition. So now this is how life changes you, so be prepared for these moments, okay? I said to him, okay, there's two of us on stage, two brothers. We have to do an improv. Let's be the Wright brothers. Let's build the first airplane. It's Kitty Hawk. We're going to launch the first airplane. So we do this little mime. There's no plane on stage. The audience is out there, just the head of the school. And I say, okay, you Orville, I'm Wilbur. Okay, Wilbur, one, two, three, on three. I bent down into a full squat push-up like this, a squat. One, two, three. My pants split. I didn't have any underwear on. Okay. I was an old hippie wearing blue jeans. I had driven down from Lewiston, Maine, in a Volkswagen bus. And I didn't think I was going to be doing full squats. And guess what? 8 months later, on my birthday, April 14th, they called me up and said, you got accepted. I said, what? I said, how did that happen? They said, well, we auditioned 1,200 people. We picked 12 out of the whole country. And I said, why did you pick me? They said, because of what happened to your underpants. Your pants split. Your pants split, okay? And so because my pants split, and because I sort of recovered the way you recovered following up the stairs, and life gave me a surprise, it was a crisis, but I turned it into an opportunity. Because I didn't blow the audition, they gave me the part. I got into school and the rest of my life unfolded, and I found my mission. My mission is to be a storyteller. You're gonna find your mission, but it's gonna come to you in a way that you never expected it. So be prepared for that. And the last thing I want to say is that I want you to do what you love to do, because if you do what you love to do, you will never feel like you have to go to work. I never in my entire life, after all the films and all the stuff and all the work in the theater that I've done, I never feel like I'm going to work. If you ask your mom and your dad and they do what they love to do, and your teachers, I bet that they love to do what they do, they don't feel like they're coming to work, they're coming to play. If you follow what you love to do, you find out what that is, that's your mission, then do what you love to do, then you will never feel like you have to go to work. And your life will be a happy life, and your marriage will be happy, and your children will be happy, and you will be able to spread that joy around the world. So be ready for surprises, because they're coming. If they're good surprises, I want you to give thanks and share the wealth. If they're not so good, I want you to give thanks anyway, because they might be a blessing in disguise. Turn the negative things into positive things. Look for the silver lining and have fun climbing that stairway of surprise. You are called the whalers. The future will rise like a whale. I want you to go out there and get it. There she blows! Thank you.
Thank you for such a refreshing speech. Dr. Timothy Lepre, chairman of the school committee, Mr. John Buckey, principal, and Mr. Kozort, superintendent, will award diplomas and scholarships.
Here we go. Row one, please stand. Marissa Joy Smith Jones, in addition to her diploma, she is being recognized with a Distinguished Young Woman Scholarship. Emily Rose Sylvia, in addition to her diploma, she is being recognized with a Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, a Byron L. Silvario American Legion Scholarship, a Nantucket Police Charitable Association Scholarship, and the Elizabeth R. Coffin Memorial Scholarship. Sean C. Allen, in addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Nantucket Garden Club Scholarship, a Knights of Columbus Scholarship, a Richard Decker Chicken Box Dart League Scholarship, Nantucket Conservation Foundation George A. Folks Environmental Studies Scholarship, and a June Bartlett Memorial Scholarship. Sean Jacob Davis, in addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Matticat Admiralty Scholarship, a Nantucket Yacht Foundation Club Scholarship, the Byron Snow Memorial Scholarship, the Dorothy Harrison Egan Foundation Scholarship, a Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, the Nantucket Rotary Club Scholarship, the Nantucket Police Charitable Association Scholarship, Cape Cod Association Scholarship, and a First Congregational Church Scholarship. Wasima Samantha Nitpat Nantiporn, in addition to her diploma, she is receiving the Nantucket Golf Club Foundation's Nantucket Scholar. Alex Bradley Milstead, in addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship and a MUSAC Scholarship. Cooper Augustus Voigt, in addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Magical Chicken Scholarship, the Nantucket Yacht Club Foundation Scholarship, Nantucket Firemen's Association Scholarship, and the Inquirer and Mirror Excellent in Written English Scholarship. Jeslyn D. Portillo, Casey Amelia Lendway, in addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a William H. Brown Scholarship, and the First Congregational Church Scholarship. Julia May Newman, in addition to her diploma, she receives a Nantucket Teachers Association Scholarship, a Matticat Admiralty Scholarship, the Distinguished Young Woman Scholarship, a MUSAC Scholarship, Nantucket Anglers Club Scholarship, and a Coffin School Trustees Scholarship. Kara J. Garufi. In addition to her diploma, she receives a UMass Amherst Cape Cod Alumni Association Scholarship, the Nantucket Island Chamber of Commerce Scholarship, the Nantucket Yacht Club Foundation Scholarship, Isabel Worth Duffy and James Duffy Scholarship, and a LaVon K. Day Memorial Scholarship. Alexa Tiso Crosby. In addition to her diploma, she receives the Dorothy Harrison Egan Foundation Scholarship, Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, and the Byron L. Silvaro American Legion Scholarship. Joseph Jerry Sweet Zeef. In addition to his diploma, he receives the Elizabeth Blackburn Scholarship, the Lucy A. Fisher Scholarship, and the Nantucket Golf Club Foundation's Nantucket Scholar. Mary Jean C. Caro. In addition to her diploma, she receives the Harry Gordon Scholarship, the Pat Martin Scholarship, St. Mary's Our Lady of the Isle John Party Scholarship, the Matticat Admiralty Scholarship, the Nantucket Island Chamber of Commerce Scholarship, the Nantucket Rotary Club Flint Ranney Scholarship, and the Corky Ranney Community Service Scholarship Award. Kate Schuyler Freed. In addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, the Nantucket Teachers Association Scholarship, Matticat Admiralty Scholarship, the Nantucket Police Charitable Association Scholarship, and the Nantucket High School Helen B. Shaw Award, which is presented to the outstanding female student athlete. Alan O. Travlioni. In addition to his diploma, he receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, the Nantucket Anglers Club Lima Machado Scholarship, the Dorothy Harrison Egan Foundation Scholarship, and a Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship. Catherine Edith Colpitz. In addition to her diploma, she is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship. Row two, please stand. Keegan Burns Bartlett. In addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Charles E. Stojak Memorial Scholarship, a Harry Gordon Scholarship, the June Bartlett Memorial Scholarship, a Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, the Nantucket Police Charitable Association Scholarship, the Cape Cod Association Scholarship, the First Congregational Church Scholarship, and a Harbor Fuel Sports Scholarship. Lily Rose Garceau. In addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, the Kenneth B. Hayes Jr. Memorial Scholarship, a Distinguished Young Woman Scholarship, the C. Pony Farm Scholarship, the First Congregational Church Scholarship, a Nantucket Art Council Scholarship, and the Edward J. Sullivan Visual Arts Scholarship. Kendall Lee Page Graham. Jackson Hollister Jellamy. Jacinia Lee Bonet. In addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship and a Nantucket Arts Council Scholarship. Jordan Ashley Emery. In addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Joshua P. Hansen Memorial Scholarship, the Maribeth Ingram Snow Scholarship, Richard Decker Chicken Box Dart League Scholarship, the Cape Cod Community College Presidential High School Scholarship, the Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, and the Robert E. Diamond Scholarship. Tajalee Javet Falconer. Keith Marcus Robinson. Dylan James Joseph Perry, in addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Matticat Admiralty Scholarship, the Inky Santa's Toys Drive Scholarship, the William H. Brown Scholarship, the Nantucket Anglers Club Pete Giles Scholarship, the Nantucket Anglers Club Lima Machado Scholarship, the Byron L. Savaro American Legion Scholarship, the Nantucket Police Charitable Association Scholarship, Cape Cod Association Scholarship, Megan Tripp Memorial, Cape Cod Foundation Scholarship, A Harbor Fuels Scholarship, the LaVon K. Day Memorial Scholarship, the Corky Ranny Community Service Scholarship, and the Nantucket High School Richard J. Porter Award, which is presented to the Outstanding Male Student Athlete. Tiffany Marie Balling. In addition to her diploma, she is receiving a Nantucket Anglers Pete Guild Scholarship, Nantucket Anglers Club Lima Machado Scholarship, the Dorothy Harrison Egan Foundation Scholarship, Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, the Byron L. Silvaro American Legion Scholarship, the Sons of the American Legion Tommy Cassano Memorial Scholarship. Ella Catherine Blossy. In addition to her diploma, she is receiving the Ruth Haviland Sutton Scholarship and the Nantucket Lodging Association Scholarship. Sean Christopher Mack. Caleb Victor Moriari Gomes. Nick Joseph Larrabee, in addition to his diploma, he is receiving the June Bartlett Memorial Scholarship and a Nantucket Police Charitable Association Scholarship. Juliette Lefebvre, in addition to her diploma, she receives a Knights of Columbus scholarship and a Harry Gordon scholarship. Kylie Megan McGuire. Antonio S. Espinosa, in addition to his diploma, he receives the Jonathan Hemingway Memorial Scholarship. Alexa R. Dragon, in addition to her diploma, she receives the Nantucket Dolphin Booster Club Scholarship, the Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, the Byron L. Silvaro American Legion Scholarship, the Elizabeth R. Coffin Scholarship, and the Margot Howes Award, which is presented to a Nantucket High School senior female student for sportsmanship in all aspects of athletics. Keaton R. W. Goddard, in addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship. Row three, please stand. Ian Jr. Smith, in addition to his diploma, he receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship and a Katherine Gardner Scholarship. Cameron James Dias, in addition to his diploma, he receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, the Rick Moran 1979 Memorial Scholarship, the Charles E. Flanagan Jr. Service Scholarship, and a Byron L. Silvaro American Legion Scholarship. Cody James Afelt. Taylor Joseph Aguirre. Mm-hmm. Nick William McGarvey. Miles Hutchison Geddes, in addition to his diploma, he receives a Matticat Admiralty Scholarship and a Nantucket Dolphin Booster Club Scholarship. Devin Higgins. Andrew James Trot Kilawa. Tanisha Mavis Emerinciana Baptiste, in addition to her diploma. In addition to her diploma, she is receiving a Distinguished Young Woman Scholarship, an American Legion Auxiliary Scholarship, the Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, and a Jesse A. Fisher Scholarship. Rakeem S. Baker, in addition to her diploma, she receives a Dorothy Harrison Egan Foundation Scholarship and a Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship. Jimmy J. Portillo Ramirez. In addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship. Ingrid Elizabeth Mendez Rivera. Carla Beatrice Tejada Limus. Kevin A. Limus Estrada. Luis D. Guevara. Row four, please stand. Damique D. Ruby. Taylor Danae Jemison. Octavio Martins Gonzalez. In addition to his diploma, he is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship. Beatrice Margaret Rain Gillum, in addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship. Brina Mary Davis Topham, in addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Nantucket Anglers Club Pete Guild Scholarship, a Nantucket Anglers Club Lima Machado Scholarship, and the Sons of the American Legion Tommy Cassano Memorial Scholarship. Diana Pudzikanaite. Samantha Lilani Mooney. In addition to her diploma, she receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Catherine Gardner Scholarship, a Nantucket Skating Scholarship, and the Sons of the American Legion Tommy Cassano Memorial Scholarship. Brittany Rose Moreau, in addition to her diploma, receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, the Nantucket Historical Association Scholarship, and a Sons of the American Legion Tommy Cassano Memorial Scholarship. Dakota Rose Mello. Lillian Hope Sylvia. Casey Elizabeth Snell. Hannah R. Pikos. Victor Paul Boucher, in addition to his diploma, receives a Harbor Fuel Sports Scholarship. Derek E. Moore, in addition to his diploma, receives a Mattaquette Admiralty Scholarship. There are only five rows. Row five, please stand. Ricardo Espinosa. Carla J. Chavez, in addition to her diploma, receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Margaret K. and Henry Terry Scholarship, a Dorothy Harrison Egan Foundation Scholarship, and a Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship. The next young man has asked me to do this a number of ways, chasing me down the hallway this afternoon, and I hope I've gotten it correct. Rick Coleman. Terrell Manuel Correa. Romario J. James. Brandon K. Harwood. Stephen V. Brown. Christian Ambrose Lombardi. Marshall Turner Slade, in addition to his diploma, receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship, and the Nantucket Firemen's Association Scholarship. Ben Michael Daniels, in addition to his diploma, receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, a Nantucket Police Charitable Association Scholarship, and the Nantucket Arts Council Scholarship. John Michael Montgomery, in addition to his diploma, receives a Ruth Haviland Sutton Scholarship, a Matticutt Admiralty Scholarship, the First Congregational Church Scholarship, the Ellen W. Thomas Scholarship, the John Hamblin Memorial Award, which is presented to a Nantucket High School senior male for sportsmanship in all aspects of athletics. Christopher Brennan Sylvia, in addition to his diploma, receives a Harry Gordon Scholarship, the Kate McClellan Soccer Scholarship, and the Nantucket Cottage Hospital Beinecke Scholarship. Vaughn J. Vittorini. Monica Lynn Fales, in addition to her diploma, is receiving a Harry Gordon Scholarship. Jack W. Decker, in addition to his diploma, is receiving a Nantucket Dolphin Booster Club Scholarship and the Nantucket Anglers Club Pete Guild Scholarship.
Please remain seated while the graduates exit and form a receiving line outside. Thank you.
The heart is a blue. Space to rent in this town, you're out of luck. And the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck. And you're not moving anywhere, you thought you found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you could lend a hand in return.